Look at my skin. I am now the physical embodiment of a rabbit. To go along with the skin change, which will not be staying like this, I also have a new background song that I'll be using more frequently. So please, let me know what you guys think of it. Hey everyone, this is Syntax, and today I'm going to be teaching you guys how to make a smooth working elevator. The reason I put so much emphasis on smooth is because I have a video on this channel on how to make a working elevator, but it is not smooth, it's as choppy as it can get, and it's horrible, so don't watch that video. This has already been done, there's already versions of it out there, there's already videos on it, but this is just my rendition, and I think it's pretty simple, and it's super cool, so come along, let me show you. Look at me recording my intro in the pregame lobby, what the heck is that? Anyway, smooth working elevators. For this, you're going to need 4 buttons, 4 triggers, 2 lock devices, and 2 teleporters. And that's it, at least for the devices. You'll also need the little doors that open and close from the military props gallery and like an elevator, obviously. If you go to galleries and select buildings, it's in any one of these. It's just like these little center doors right here. Yeah, these 3, those are what you're gonna need for the doors. But anyway, let's get into it. First of all, the design for your elevator can be whatever you want, whatever you think works best in your map. I don't know what aesthetics you're gonna have, but you just need to design an elevator. All I did was took this elevator from the Art Deco prop gallery, I think, and then I took the military door and I like shrunk it down and threw it inside of it, you know, something like that. Made sure everything was centered. Again, you can use whatever you want and set it up however you like. There's also this little extra bit from the shark prop gallery, but again, you can line it up aesthetically however you need to. Just make sure you have elevator doors that can open like this, because the military prop gallery stuff does that. Now, I'm showing you a 2-floor design, but obviously this would work with more floors if you were to set it up correctly, but just keep in mind that this only works for 2 floors. Anyway, inside your elevator, you're going to have a button that is going to take you to the 2nd floor. Let me show you how that's done. Make sure you set up the settings correctly. You can trigger it an infinite amount of times. There's no delay. I turn the trigger sound on and it's enabled at game start, and I have my interaction text be floor 2. Obviously for the 2nd floor it will be floor 1, but you want to just set it up so that it sends a signal when you interact with it. So for me, that's channel 1. Same thing for the elevator on the 2nd floor. Just change the interaction text to floor 1 because you're going to be going down, and just have it send on a different channel. So for me, that's 3. Now, this next part is important because it uses the new teleporter settings, which enables this whole thing to be perfectly smooth. Grab yourself your teleporter and you're going to want to stagger them evenly with the floors of the elevators. Now, there are a couple ways to do this. First, take your first teleporter, whatever that is, and I 8-snapped it so that the bottom of it, you see the bottom of the teleporter, it's like slightly phased into the ground. That's perfect. That will be smooth when you're teleporting. Now, to ensure that this is a height that is not going to drop you when you teleport to it, you want to take this teleporter, make sure building to prop is turned off, and then when you copy it and move it upward, it's going to be exactly where it needs to be. And obviously, if you do the same thing with the elevator, you can see that they move in sync. So like, just make sure building the prop is turned off, grab a hover platform, and when you move them up, they will be perfectly equidistant. Again, you're just doing that to make sure that the distance is the correct distance and that the teleportation is smooth. If you wanted to take this elevator and whatnot and move it higher, it doesn't matter as long as you're moving the teleporter with it, but I just have this right above for simplicity reasons. Anyway, go ahead to your first teleporter and set it up with a teleporter target group. That is going to be group A for me, and you're going to want to set up the settings so that none of it is visible. Conserve momentum needs to be on, and face player and teleporter direction needs to be relative. I made the effect radius 3 meters, but honestly, I don't know if it has to be that big. I think it just has to have an effect radius, and make sure maintain relative position is turned on. Now, this is going to activate when receiving from channel 2. Now, you might remember I haven't set anything on channel 2. Well, I actually have. I just haven't showed you. There's a trigger I have set up here that receives a signal from that button, and then a few seconds later sends a signal to that teleporter to activate it. You can see right here I have everything turned off. It can trigger an infinite amount of times, and the delay is 3 seconds. So this triggers when receiving from 1, and when triggered sends on 2. So once it's triggered from 1, 3 seconds later it will send a signal on 2, activating this teleporter, which then will teleport us this relative distance. Of course, with your second teleporter, you want to make sure you have it set up to teleporter group A or whatever group matches said teleporter, and same thing for this one. It has teleporter target group B, and this is obviously teleporter group B. be. Now, I did the same thing for this button. You remember this one sends on channel 3. There is a trigger back here that triggers when receiving from 3, and when triggered, it transmits on 4, and that activates this teleporter, which then, of course, teleports you downward. Okay. I know that's a lot and my popsicle is melting, but I'll go over it again real quick just in case anyone is behind. Button sends a signal to a trigger. 3 seconds later, it will send a signal to activate this teleporter, teleporting you upwards after 3 seconds. Same thing with the second floor button. It sends a signal on channel 3, which sends to the trigger. 3 seconds later, that sends on channel 4 to the teleporter, activating it, teleporting you downwards. Hopefully that makes sense. Now, the other thing I have is 2 lock devices. These are set up to lock and close when receiving from the same channels that you initially hit with those buttons inside the elevator. So for the first floor, it's channel 1. I have these set up to lock and close when receiving from channel 1. And same with this, I have it set up to lock and close when receiving from channel 3 because, well, that is channel 3 in there. Now, to make it even more realistic, you don't have to do this, but I did it. I actually put a second set of triggers that receive from those buttons that make the doors open after you're already teleported up to that floor. This trigger on top of my upward elevator button gets a signal from 1, and then when triggered, it sends on 6, but it sends 5 seconds later. As you can see right there, the delay is 5 seconds. What that does is after receiving a signal from 1, you get teleported up to the top floor, and that was 3 seconds. So once 2 more seconds go by, this receives a signal that both unlocks and opens the door from that trigger, which is on channel 6. Same thing happening with this lock device down here. It unlocks and opens when receiving from 5, and there is a trigger back here that triggers when receiving from 3, which is our second floor elevator button, and then 5 seconds later it will send a signal on 5, unlocking and opening the door. The last 2 devices are these buttons out here. They are actually used to call the elevator if it is not on the floor a player occupies. You can see that this button, you set up the settings, it can be triggered an infinite amount of times, but the most important thing is that this is disabled on game start. You're going to enable it when receiving from the same channel that is teleporting us upwards. So for us, that's channel 2. And of course, the teleporter that activates that sends us downward, it's going to disable it because then the elevator will technically be on the bottom floor and you won't want to be able to call it if it's already there. Of course, if the elevator is not on this floor, the door is also going to be locked. So this button sends a signal on channel 5, which if you remember, unlocks and opens this door. Same thing with this button up here. The only difference is it's enabled on game starts. You can see that it enables when receiving from the same channel that is sending us downward and then disables from the same channel that is sending us upward, and then of course if you interact with it, it will unlock and open this door via this lock device. Okay, that was a lot. I'm gonna start the game and then verbally explain it again. Maybe I'll put some diagrams or whatever, and then hopefully this works for you guys. Okay, as you can see, when I approach my elevator, obviously the doors open for me, and this button is not enabled because the elevator is on the first floor. This door is locked and this button is enabled because this is the second floor elevator, so that is all good right there as well. Now, upon pushing this button, a multitude of things are going to happen. First, this door is going to lock and close when receiving from that button. Second thing that's happening is this bottom trigger is getting triggered, and 3 seconds later, it sends a signal to our teleporter that teleports us upward. That button will also send a signal to this trigger to trigger the opening door mechanism 5 seconds later, so when we're on the second floor, the door opens after we're already up there. Anyway, if you have everything set up correctly, it should look something like this. You're gonna see that I click the button, this door locks, I can walk around, wait a little bit, you can see that I moved to the second floor, and then after a couple seconds, the door opens and I am on the second floor. Seamless. And now that I am actually on the second floor, the elevator is technically on this floor, this button no longer works, and the call elevator button of course works for this floor, and the door is locked. And of course I am now in the second floor elevator. The same thing is going to happen. If I hit floor 1, I can just run around a little bit, I will wait, 3 seconds later I'll get teleported downward, and then the door will open and we are on floor 1 again. And as you can see, the second floor elevator is locked again, and I can recall the elevator. Just to show you that the call elevator button does actually work, if I go up to floor 2 again, you can run around inside this, it doesn't really matter, you'll get teleported to the top floor. You can see that if I call the elevator down here, it comes to me. But yeah, that is the smooth working elevator. Objectively, this is only meant to be purely aesthetic. Because of the new teleporter settings and using conserved momentum, it doesn't matter what way we're facing and how we're moving in these elevators, we will always get teleported that relative distance, so it makes it seem like the elevator is actually moving and it's perfect and it's seamless and it's wonderful. Obviously, you can just stand still when you're in the elevator, but that's just kind of like the old elevator design. It's not really seamless, but like with this one, I can run around and you don't even really tell that you get teleported downward and then you're on the first floor. It's almost like it's magic. If any of it didn't make sense, I did go through all the settings. I made sure that you could pause the video at any time to make sure everything is set up how you need to set it up, because it is quite a few devices and it's not that complicated, but it's easy to get lost in what triggers send where and why. But anyway, that is the smooth working elevator and how to make it inside of your maps. I really do hope this video helped you out, guys, and yeah, this has been Syntax. Later.